Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about exercise 1.6 part 2. Okay. Exercise 1.6 part 2. Already we saw the part 1. Okay, so we are going to continue the next part. Okay, already we completed 5 sums. Okay, so today we are going to start question number 6. Okay, in examination 50% of the students passed in mathematics and 70% of the students paused in science, while 10% of the students failed in both subjects. Okay, the first two informations in the paused. Okay, that second, the 10% of the students failed in both subjects. Okay, 300 students paused in at least one subject. 300 students paused in at least one subject. Find the total number of students who appeared in the examination if they took examinations in only two subjects. Okay, so in this question, paused percentage and failed percentage is both also given. Okay, so first you have to separate. Okay, So we want to find the total number of students who appeared in the examination in only two subjects, if they took only two subjects. Okay, so I am taking, let the students who appeared in the examination B, yes. Okay, so what I want to find, that I can take x. Okay, let the students who appeared in the examination be x. Okay, then let the percentage, let the percentage of students who failed in mathematics, be M. Okay, so in the question, the number of student, percentage of students paused in mathematics is given, but I take the percentage of students who failed in mathematics be M. Okay, like this you have to take for science also. Okay, let the percentage of students who failed in science B, yes. Okay. Then, so we know that 50% of the students passed in mathematics. Okay. So from that we are going to find percentage of failed in mathematics. So we know that already the percentage means it's out of 100. So from that you have to subtract the percentage of passed. You will get the percentage of failed. Okay. So failed percentage in max. Okay. So we know that it's a percentage means it's out of 100. So 100 percentage minus pass percentage. Pass percentage of max is 50. So 100 percentage minus 50 percentage is equal to, you will get 50 percentage. So 50 percentage of the students failed in max. Okay. Then next one. Failed percentage in science. The question, pass percentage of the students is in science is 70%. Okay, so failed means you have to subtract from 100. So 100 minus 70% is equal to 30%. Okay, so the next one, failed in both subjects. Failed percentage in both subject. Is equal to 10%. It is given in the question. Okay. So now we are going to find percentage of students failed in at least one subject. At least means either max or either science. That means or means we are going to use union. Okay. So n of m union s is equal to, we know that the formula a union b, that is equal to n of a plus n of b plus minus n of a intersection b. So like this you have to use for m union s. So n of m plus n of s minus n of m intersection s. Here we are talking about only the failed percentage. Okay, so you can write this n of m, that is max failed percentage is 50% plus for science 30%, then both is 10%. Okay, so we will get 80 minus 10%, so that is equal to 70%. This is n of m union s. So that is percentage of students failed in at least one subject. At least one subject. Okay. That is equal to 70%. But we are going to find the total number of the percentage of students who have passed in at least one subject. So the opposite. Okay. So percentage of students passed in at least one subject. So already we found at least failed in at least one subject we found. Okay, so now we are going to find passed in at least one subject. So that means you have to subtract from 100%. Okay, so 100% minus 70%, so that is equal to, we will get 30%. Why we are finding this? Because 300 students passed in at least one subject. Okay, so they are giving 300 students passed in at least one subject. So we know we want to know that how many percentage is 300 students. Okay, so for that only we are finding this percentage of students passed in at least one subject. Okay, so we are taking x is the total number of students. Okay, so that means 30% of students, 30% of total number of students is equal to 300. Okay, so therefore 30% of x is equal to 300. Okay, so percentage means we know that out of 100, so 30 by 100 into x is equal to 300. Okay, so we want to find the value of x. So x is equal to 300. This terms 30 by 100, it will be comes reciprocal. So 100 by 30. Okay, so 0, 0 cancel. 3 means you will get 100. Okay, 100 into 10 is equal to 1000. So therefore total number of students who appeared in the examination is equal to 1000. Okay, so your sixth sum over. Next, question number 7. A and B are two sets such that n of A minus B is equal to 32 plus x comma n of b minus a, or b difference a, is equal to 5x, and n of a intersection b is equal to x. Illustrate the information by means of a Venn diagram. Given that n of a is equal to n of b, then calculate the value of x. Okay, so we are going to solve using Venn diagrams. Okay, so we are taking two sets, that is a and b. Okay, we know that this is the part of A intersection B. Okay, so A intersection B is x. Okay, so n of A difference B, A difference B means this except in A circle, except the part of intersection, it's called A difference B. Okay, so this is 32 plus x. Okay, then next one, B difference A, is 5x. Okay, so what is the condition is given? N of A is equal to N of B. Okay, given N of A is equal to N of B. Okay, so N of A means, this full circle. Okay, this full circle is A. Okay, so you have to, if you finding n of a, you have to check, you can add this and this both also. Okay, so that means n of a is equal to 32 plus x plus x, okay, that is equal to n of b means you can take this circle, okay, so that is this full circle, okay, so that means you can take this 5x, then this x also, okay, so that is 5x plus x, okay, from the Venn diagram. So we can add this 32 plus x plus x. So 32 plus 2x is equal to 5x plus x. 5x plus x is equal to 6x. Okay. So 32, we are going to find the x value. Okay. So 32 is equal to 6x. This 2x comes this side, it will be negative. Okay. So 6x minus 2x, you will get 4x is equal to 32. Okay. So x is the value of 32 divided by 4, because 4x means 4 into x. Okay. So it will be comes this side, it will be division. Okay. So 32 divided by 4. How many times? 8 times. Okay. So x is equal to 8. So the sum over. Then next question number 8. Okay. Out of 500 cars owners investigated, 400 owned car A and 200 owned car B and 50 owned both cars A and B. Is this data is correct or not? Okay. So the given data is correct or not, we want to check. So total n of out of 500 cars owned investigated, that means A union B. Okay, first you have to write what is A, what is B. Okay, let A be the set of people owned car A. Okay, then next, let capital B be the set of people owned car B. Okay, so n of a is equal to owned car A is 400. Okay, so n of a is equal to 400, then n of b is equal to 200, then that both 50 owned both. So both means we know that it's a intersection part, so a intersection b is equal to 50. Okay, so that for out of 500 cars owners investigated, that is your n of A union B. N of A union B is equal to 500. Okay, so we know that n of A union B formula. Okay, so we know that n of A union B is equal to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. Okay, so you are going to apply the values of n of a intersection b and the n of a union b. Okay, so we should check if both sides are equal or not. Okay, so n of a union b is equal to 500, that is equal to n of a 400 plus n of b 200 minus n of A intersection B is equal to 50. Okay, so that is equal to 400 plus 200 600 minus 50 is equal to 550, but we are getting the A union B is equal to 500. Okay, this is not equal to 550. Therefore, the given data, is incorrect. If you are getting the correct data, the formula will be satisfied. Okay, but here the formula, you are getting the left hand side and right hand side different answers. Okay, so the given data is incorrect. Okay. Next. Question number 9. This is very important model. Okay. So, just listen carefully. In a colony, 275 families buy Tamil newspaper, 150 families buy English newspaper, 45 families buy Hindi newspaper, and 125 buy Tamil and English, 17 families buy English and Hindi, and 5 families buy Tamil and Hindi, and 3 families buy all the 3 newspaper. Okay, if each family buy at least one newspaper, okay, so each family buy at least any one of the newspaper, okay, then find number of families buy only one and number of families buy at least two, then total number of families. Okay, so this is very important model, just listen carefully. Let T comma E and H represent families buying Tamil newspaper, English newspaper and Hindi newspaper. Respectively, that means that T denotes Tamil and E denotes English and H denotes Hindi. Okay, so from the question we are going to write the details. Okay, that is N of T, that means number of peoples by Tamil newspaper. Okay, so N of T is equal to 275. Okay, then N of E is equal to 150, then N of H is equal to 45. Okay, then N of T intersection E, that means that both Tamil and English, okay, both Tamil and English, that is equal to 125. Then like this, N of E intersection H, that means the English newspaper and Hindi newspaper, that is equal to 7. Then N of T intersection H is equal to 5. Then all the three means N of T intersection E intersection H, okay, that is equal to 5. Okay, so we are going to use the Venn diagram. Okay, so this is my Tamil newspaper, this is my English and this is Hindi. Okay, if you draw the Venn diagram, you can draw the circles, it's big, little bit big. Okay, because we are going to enter the details inside the diagram. Okay, so we know that Tamil is 275 and English 150. Okay, then Hindi 45. Intersection part, this is T intersection E. This is intersection part. Okay, this is T intersection E, means this full spaces is intersection. Okay, but only Tamil and English means this part alone. Okay, this is T and E. Here this part will be all the three. Okay, all the three is what? 3. Okay, so here you can write 3. Then here 125. Here 125. Then here 17. Then here 5. Okay, so listen carefully what we are going to do. First, we should know that only two newspapers, this two part, this part is Tamil and English both. Okay, but in this, that all the three newspaper also included. Okay, so if you are going to find only the Tamil and English, means you should subtract here this common part of 3. Okay, so what do you get here? 122. Okay, so that means only Tamil and English newspapers buyers is equal to 122. Okay, so like this you have to find English and Hindi also. Okay, so this part is English and Hindi. Okay, so from this, if you subtract 3, you will get only English and Hindi, that is equal to 14. Okay, like this here also you have to subtract, that means you will get 2. Okay, then next one, this 275 is Tamil newspapers, number of peoples, buyers of Tamil newspaper. Okay, in this included that two English paper buyers and all the three also. So from this you are going to subtract all these circles. Okay, all these values, if you are taking this circle, you are going to subtract 122, 3 and 2. Okay, so then only you will get one number of buyers, only Tamil newspapers. So from this, 122 plus 3 plus 2, so that is equal to 275 minus 122 plus 3, 125, 127. Okay, so that is equal to, you will get 148. Okay, like this you have to find for another sets also. Okay, so 150 minus 122 plus 3 plus 14. Okay, that is equal to 150 minus 122 plus 3, 125, 125 plus 14, 139. Okay, that is equal to 11. Then next for this circle. Okay, so this circle means 45 minus 2 plus 3 plus 14. Okay, what do you get? 45 minus 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 14, 19. Okay, that is equal to, what do you get? 26. Okay, are you understand this Venn diagram? This is you can do it carefully. Okay, if you change any one place, if you are doing wrong in any one place, you will get fully wrong. Okay. So from this we are going to find first one, number of families by only one newspaper. Only one newspaper means this part. Okay, this 148, 11, 26, these are the number of buyers of only one newspaper. Okay, so first one, number of families, number of families by only one newspaper only one newspaper is equal to 148 plus 11 plus 26 okay so that is equal to you will get 185 okay then next one number of families by at least two means minimum two that means that maximum also applicable okay that is one at least two means that minimum two that means maximum also possible so you can take that three papers by us also you can take this okay number of families by at least two newspapers at least two newspapers that means minimum so maximum also applicable so 122 plus 2 plus 14 plus 3 okay this part okay that two parts is 122 14 2 and 3 okay this is at least means if they ask only two means you should not take this three okay you can use only 122 14 and 2 if they ask at least means you can take the maximum part also but only two means you can take 122 14 and 2 okay are you clear so if you add what do you get you will get 141 okay then third subdivision total number of families in the colony total number of families in the colony so using Venn diagram after the subtraction what are the values you are getting 148 122 11 14 3 2 and 26 everything you should add you will get total number of families okay so that is equal to 148 plus 122 plus 11 plus 14 plus 3 plus 2 plus 26 okay that is equal to if you add you will get 326 okay that's all this is very important model okay if you are not understand you can visualize two or three times this video okay then next question number 10 okay a survey of 100,000 farmers found that 600 grew paddy 300 grew ragi and 280 grew corn and 120 grew paddy and ragi and 100 grew ragi and corn and 80 grew paddy and corn if each farmer grew at least any one of the above three okay so then find the number of farmers who grew all the three means union part intersection part we want to find okay all the three means intersection part we want to find okay let p r and c represent sets of farmers grew paddy means what do you know that nell okay va ragi and ragi kelvaragu okay and corn gone respectively. Okay. So from the question we are going to convert into symbols. Okay, that is N of P union R union C, that is total number of farmers 1000. Okay, then N of P is equal to 600, N of R is equal to 350, and N of C is equal to 280, and means you are going to use intersection. Okay, all then N of P intersection R, that is Paddy and Rogi, is equal to 120. Then N of R intersection C is equal to 100. Then N of P intersection C is equal to 80. Okay, what we want to find? The number of farmers who grew all the three means N of P intersection R intersection C. Okay, we don't know that, so we can take X. Okay, so now we are going to apply the formula N of P union R union C P union R union C is equal to N of P plus N of R plus N of C minus N of P intersection R minus R intersection C minus N of P intersection C, then plus N of P intersection R intersection C. Okay, you should apply the values here. That is 1000 is equal to 600 plus 350 plus 280 minus 120 minus 100 minus 80 plus X. Okay, we are going to find the X value. Okay, so if you are adding the positive value, 600 plus 350 plus 280, you will get 1230. Then negative values, 120, 100, 80, you will get 300. Okay, plus X. Okay, if you subtract 300 from 1230, means you will get 930. Okay, if you subtract 300 from 1230, means you will get 930 plus X. Okay, this side you have 1000. Okay, we are going to find X value. Okay, so X is equal to this 930 comes this side, so you will get X is equal to 70. So what do you take X? X is the number of farmers who grew all the three. Therefore, number of farmers grew all the three is equal to 70 farmers. Okay. Next is some question number 11. In the adjacent diagram, in the adjacent diagram, if n of u is equal to 125, y is 2 times of x. Y is 2 times of x. And z is 10 more than x. Find the value of x, y, z. Okay. So, Venn diagram is given. Okay. U is equal to, n of u is equal to 125. Okay. So, A, B, and C. This is Z, X, Y. Here 4, 3, 17, and 6. That outside 5. Okay. So, what is the condition is given? N of u is equal to 125. The condition is y is 2 times x. Y is 2 times. Times, the word times denotes multiplication. So, y is equal to 2x. Okay. 2 times means 2 into x. Okay. Then, z is, that is, z is equal to, it's 10 more than x. More than means, it's a plus. Okay. More than means adhigama. So, 10 more than x. So, x avida 10 adhigama. So, x plus 10. X plus 10. Okay. So, you are going to find n of u is equal to, n of u means that universal set means you are going to add all the values what is given in the rectangle. Okay. So, n of u is equal to, what are the values given in the Venn diagram? Everything you can add. That is your universal set. Okay. So, x plus 4 plus y plus 17. Then, plus 3 plus 6 plus z plus 5. Okay. So, x plus 4 plus y plus 17 plus 3 plus 6 plus z plus 5. Okay. So, n of u is equal to what? 125. Okay. So, we know that y is equal to 2x. Y is equal to 2x. So, x plus 4 plus, you can replace the value for x, y. Y is equal to 2x plus 17 plus 3 plus 6 plus z is equal to x plus 10. So, you can replace it plus 5. Okay. So, now we are going to add all the values. X, 2x, x. So, totally 4x. Okay. Here the coefficient of x is 1. Here also the coefficient of x is 1. Okay. So, 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 2, 4x. Then, add the numbers. You will get 4 plus 17, 21, 21 plus 3, 24, 24 plus 6, 30, 30 plus 10, 40, 40 plus 5, 45, okay, that is equal to 125, okay. So, if you want to find the x value, 4x is equal to this 45, its transpose means you will get negative. So, 125 minus 45, so that is equal to 80, is equal to 4x, okay. So, x is equal to what? 80 divided by 4. What do you get? You will get x is equal to 20. Okay. So, your x value is equal to 20. Then, we want to find the y value. Y is equal to what? 2x. Okay. So, therefore, y is equal to 2 into 20, that is equal to, y is equal to 40. Okay. Then next one, what do you want to find? Z is equal to x plus 10. Z is equal to x plus 10. We know that x is the value of 20. So, 20 plus 10, that is equal to 30. Okay, therefore, the value of The value of x is equal to 20 and y is equal to 40, then z is equal to 30. Okay, that's all. Next, question number 13. In a cycle, 50 students, each one come to school by bus or bicycle or on foot. Okay. 25 by bus, 20 by bicycle, 30 on foot, and 10 students by all the three. Now, how many students come to exactly by two mode of transfers? Okay. So, you are going to draw the Venn diagram. First, you can take let A, B and C represent students come to school by bus, bicycle and foot respectively. Okay, so n of A union B union C, that is total number of students, n of A union B union C is equal to 50, then n of A is equal to 25 and n of B is equal to 20, then n of C is equal to 30, n of A intersection B intersection C is equal to 10. Okay, we are going to find exactly two modes. So A is represent bus, B is represent bicycle and C is represent foot. Okay, so exactly two modes means this part. Okay, so we don't know that x like this part, so this is y and this part, okay, that is z. Okay, so this x plus y plus z we are going to find. Okay, that all the three is 10. So here 25, here 20, then here 30. Okay. So the same way we are going to use x plus z plus 10. Okay. If you are subtracting, you will get 25 minus 10, 15, here 10. Okay. 15. Minus x minus z. Okay, then here x plus 10 plus y. Okay, so that is equal to, if you subtract 10, you will get 10 minus x minus y. 10 minus x minus y. Then here 30 minus z plus 10 plus y. Okay, so what do you get? 30 minus 10, 20. Minus y minus z. Okay, so we know that the universal set means you will add all the values. Okay, so the total number of students is equal to 50. Okay, So what are the values are in the Venn diagram? Everything you can add. Okay. So what do you get? 15 minus x minus z plus x plus 10 minus x minus y plus 10 plus z plus 20 minus z minus y is equal to 50. Okay. So you can subtract any plus and minus element are there. Okay. So minus y plus y cancel. Then plus z minus z cancel. So what do you get remaining? Plus x minus x cancel. So you can, if you add the numbers, what do you get? 15 plus 10, 25. 25 plus 10, 35. 35 plus 20, 55. So 55 minus x minus y minus z is equal to 50. Okay. You want to find the value of x plus y plus z. So 55, you can take this 50, this side, okay, 50 is equal to this x minus y minus z comes that side, it will be positive, x plus y plus z, okay, so that is equal to 5. So exactly two modes using only 5 students, okay, so therefore number of students come to school exactly by 2 modes of transport is equal to 5. Okay. Your exercise 1.6 over. Then only one more example is there. Okay. It is difficult. So I will teach that. Example 1.35. Example 1.35. Okay. This is very big. This is a big problem. Okay. So listen carefully. A survey was conducted among 200 magazine subscribers of 3 different magazines. Okay. So therefore, total number of subscribers. This also you should write in your note. Okay. Example sum, but no problem, you have to write in your note. Okay. Total number of subscribers is equal to 200. Okay. So we are talking about 3 magazines. Okay. So you can make a table. So A, B, C do not subscribe. Here subscribe. Okay. So a survey was conducted among 200 magazine subscribers of 3 different magazines A, B, C. It was found that 75 members do not subscribe magazine A. Do not subscribe magazine A is 75. Okay. So for each magazine 200 members. So that means do not subscribe 75 means subscribe is 125, because 200 minus 75, 125. Okay, from the given data we are going to find the number of subscribers. Okay, then next one, 100 members do not subscribe magazine B. So this is 100, so 200 minus 100 you will get 100. Okay, then next C, magazine C, 50 members do not subscribe magazine C. So here 50 means here you will get 150. Okay, so 125 subscribes at least one of the three magazine. 125 subscribe at least two. At least two means that maximum also possible. Okay, so we are using the Venn diagram. Okay, so A 125 and B 100, their universal set no need. Okay, so A 125, B 100 and C 150. Okay, so here you can take A, B, C, here X, R, Y, Z. Okay. 125 subscribe at least 2. At least 2 means minimum 2 magazines. Okay. That means maximum also possible. That means 3 magazines also possible. Therefore, that 125 is equal to X plus Y plus Z plus R. At least 2 means that 2 also, minimum 2, maximum 3. Okay. At least means minimum 2, maximum 3. So this whole part will be added. Okay. So what you are going to write? First you want to find number of members who subscribe exactly to. Exactly to means this X, Y and Z. Okay. So first one we are going to find exactly two magazines, that means X plus Y plus Z. Okay, then second one, what the number of members who subscribe only one magazine. Only one magazine means find A plus B plus C. Okay, next from the details, N of A union B union C is equal to 200. Okay, then N of A is equal to 125, N of B is equal to 100, then N of C is equal to 150, N of A intersection B is equal to X plus R. X plus R, X plus R, then N of B intersection C is equal to Y plus R, then N of A intersection C is equal to Z plus R, then N of A intersection B intersection C is equal to R. Okay, so already I said that 125 is equal to at least 2 means that 3 magazines also possible. So X plus Y plus Z plus R is equal to 125. Okay, this is equation number 1. Okay, so we know the formula. We know that N of A union B union C is equal to N of A plus N of B plus N of C minus N of A intersection B minus N of B intersection C minus N of A intersection C plus N of A intersection B intersection C. Okay, so we know the values, we are going to apply the values here. Okay, so 200 is equal to 125 plus 100 plus 150. Here minus A intersection B. A intersection B is x plus r, but here minus. So minus x minus r and minus B intersection C is y plus r. So this also you will get here minus y minus r, then minus z minus r, then plus r. Okay, so if you are minus r plus r will be omitted. So what do you get? If you are adding the numbers, 375 minus all the variables having minus, so you can take the minus outside. So what do you get? Here two r's are there, you can separate it. X plus y plus z plus r, then minus r. Okay, y means we know the value is x plus y plus z plus r. Okay, but here two r's are there, so we are not able to apply. So you can take separately one r. So 375 minus, you are using equation number 1. What do you get? Here 125. So 125 minus r. So if you subtract, what do you get? 250 minus r here is equal to 200. Okay, so you want to find the value of r, you can take this r, this side. So 250 minus 200 is equal to 50. So therefore r is equal to 50. Okay, so in the first subdivision, what we want to find? Number of members who subscribe exactly to magazine. Already I told you exactly to magazine means x plus y plus az. Okay, so number of members who subscribe exactly exactly two magazines. Okay, we know that is equal to x plus y plus z. Okay, so we are using equation number 1, that is equal to x plus y plus z plus r is equal to 125. Okay, we know the r value. If you subtract here, what do you get? X plus y plus z plus 50 is equal to 125. Okay, so x plus y plus z only we need, so that is equal to 125 minus 50, that is equal to 75. Okay, then second subdivision, what do you want to find? Number of members who subscribe only one magazine. Number of members who subscribe only one magazine. Only one magazine. That means we should find the value of A plus B plus C. Okay, so therefore we know that from the Venn diagram, A plus B plus C plus X plus Y plus Z plus R is equal to 200. Okay, so adding all the values, you will get 200. Already we know that this is the value of 125. So A plus B plus C plus 125 is equal to 200. So A plus B plus C is equal to 200 minus 125. That is equal to 75. Okay. So therefore, number of members who subscribe only one magazine is equal to 75. Okay. Thank you, students. Your first chapter over.